Welcome to Front Page Film Studios in Silver Spring, Maryland. My name is Stephen Best, filling in for David Vandy, who's on assignment. The video that you're about to watch was filmed here at Front Page Film Studios 2 years ago. The subject is the Reverend Jabrila Sambuka Bangura of Christ's Lord Ministries in Virginia. The title of this video is called Judge Not. We shouldn't judge. But as you watch this video, think about this Bible scripture. In Matthew 7:1, it says, "Judge not, that you be not judged." As you watch this video, think about that scripture. Let's watch the video.
This is Mohammed Yahya Sila, president of Sila Communications International, an African World News Global Report in Atlanta, Georgia, United States of America. I'm actually here in the studios of Front Page Studios in Silver Springs, Maryland. With me is Reverend Jabrila Sambuka Bangura, senior pastor and founder of Christ is Lord Ministries, both in Virginia and Maryland. There is something unique about Reverend Bangura, and that is Reverend Bangura was born a Muslim in Sierra Leone. His father is Sheikh Ibrahim Suri Bangura. Reverend Jabrila Bangura called for prayer in a mosque, in his village in Sierra Leone. But then his life changed. Suddenly, his life changed. His life changed just from a greeting from a friend. We are going to ask Reverend Bangura to tell us something about himself and what happened to him and how his journey has been since his life changed from being a Muslim to becoming a Christian. Welcome, Reverend Bangura.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mohammed Sila, and God bless you. Nice meeting you.
Reverend Bangura, this is the thing that baffles all of us. We see you, you have become an extraordinary figure in the United States, all of a sudden. Who are you? Who is Reverend Jabrila Sambuka Bangura? Tell us something about yourself.
Praise be to God. I first of all want to thank the Almighty God and our Savior Jesus Christ for bringing me this far. As you've heard, and my name is Reverend Jabrila Sambuka Bangura, the second son of 8 children. I was born in the northern province of Sierra Leone, Kamakwie, and then the Lord has been so good to me. And I started as a Muslim, and today, thank God, it's a long journey.
Now, you were born a Muslim. You said you came from a Muslim family. How did you become a Christian? What happened?
Well, it's a long journey. It all started in 1987. In my very hometown, Kamakwie, we have the Wesleyan Mission. A friend of mine invited me in one of the camp meetings. I used to oppose, criticize, and condemn Christians about the virgin birth and the Trinity. I was so skeptical about their teaching and doctrines. And this young man invited me in one of the camp meetings. I attended the camp meeting. I was just there just to visit. I went to the church. My purpose was not to become a Christian, but when my parents heard about me, the son of a cleric, going to the mosque or going to the church, I was asked out of my home. And since then, I was shown love. I was handed over a Bible, and that Bible became my friend up to this day.
And so are you telling me that the road to your Christian faith actually arose from the love that the Christian showed you after the Muslim's parent, your Muslim parents threw you out of your home?
Yes, Mr. Sila. The love they showed me was this. As a teenager, I have nobody to pay my school fees. I have nobody to help me out. In that time of destitution, they gave me a Bible. And this young man showed me a passage from scripture that if your father and mother forsake you, the Lord will take care. And they took care of me. They gave me all I was looking for. But the greatest of all, they showed me love and gave me Jesus.
Now, did you start your Christian life in Sierra Leone?
Yes, I started my Christian life in Sierra Leone, in my hometown with the Wesleyan Mission.
Okay, now how did you manage to become a reverend?
To God be the glory. It's a wonderful question. I was not even thinking, I was not planning that I'll become a Christian or a reverend. Like I said earlier, my purpose was just to visit and go home. But this Bible that was handed over to me, I fell in love with the Bible, reading the scriptures, and begin to function in the affairs of the church. And while we were going out on visitation, outreach meetings, they used me to preach, to do exhortation. And it was from those exhortations in Sierra Leone, hospital ministries, prison ministries, evangelism, that my gift was discovered and identified. And they called me to see if I'll be able to make it into the pastoral field. But I told them, no, I'm too young to go into the ministry. And what would my parents say about me becoming a pastor? And while praying and seeking the face of God, the Lord spoke to me that I'm calling you and I want to make use of you to go out, rescue the perishing, and care for the dying. And that's the way the Lord brought me into the spotlight. It was December 13, 1992, that I preached my first message at the Faith Assembly of God Church, Bass Street, Brookfields.
Now, Reverend Bangura, I'm amazed at how your name is becoming a household name in the United States. People have spoken about you as being this miracle child from Sierra Leone. You are almost becoming a pride of that West African country. What do you think of this?
Well, one great thing, it is the Lord's doing. I am just an ordinary man from a poor background, the son of an Islamic priest. You know, but the Bible says God will use the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. So I want to give God that glory, because had it not been the Lord who was on my side, I would not come this far. So that pride, that blessings, and all the goodness that I'm enjoying now, all honor and glory is due to the Almighty God.
Well, that is good. I mean, obviously, it's always good to give glory to God for the blessings He showers upon us. Now, there's something that just strikes me here. Your parents virtually disowned you for becoming a Christian. You know, I'm talking to you as a Muslim. Okay, I'm a devout Muslim. I pray 5 times a day. It so happened that I have so many Christian friends, Christian pastors and reverends, and I have been privileged to speak in churches, and I mean, this is something interesting. So I can relate a little bit to where you're coming from in a different way. Now, your parents, according to what you're telling me, virtually disowned you for being a Christian. You used to call for prayer in the mosque. You read the Quran. You actually mastered certain portions of the Holy Quran. Now that you've become a reverend, you are preaching in the churches, you are having a following, how do your parents look at you at the moment? How do they perceive you? In their mind's eye, who is Jibrila Sapunka Bangura today?
It's very interesting, Mr. Sila. My father is so happy about me now. But he's still, jokingly, when we joke at home, even right now he's with me in the United States. I brought him in July 2009. And he's still saying to me, Jibrila, I'll be happy for you to come back to Islam, so that when I die, you will wash my body and you will see me one day when we get over to the other side. So that when we stand before the Malik Yawmiddin, in Islam, the Malik Yawmiddin is the master of the day of judgment. You know, for now, my father is so happy concerning me, and he comes to my church, he pays visit to my church. Even New Year's Eve, he was there with me. The only thing he's advising me is for me to be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Because as long as I live a perfect life, I live a decent life for God, then one day I'll be able to see God, who is the creator of the heavens and the earth. But for now, they're happy for me, even though they were bitter at first, because nobody will be happy. If you're a carpenter, you want your son or your daughter to practice your trade or to learn your trade. But for me to become a Christian, at first, it was a disgrace to them for the son of an Islamic cleric to be converted to Christianity. And now I'm grown up, he said, well, he told me the right path. If I choose to be a Christian, then I have all to answer for myself on that day of judgment.
Now with me is Sheikh Ebrahim Sori Bangura, the father of Reverend Jibril Sapunka Bangura. Welcome, sir. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Yeah. Sheikh, how are you feeling?
Well, fine. I thank God.
You thank God.
Yes.
I have been talking with your son about his life. I'm so delighted, I'm so happy that you're available to be in the studio here with me this afternoon. My name is Mohamed Yahya Sila. I'm also from Sierra Leone, and I understand you are from Sierra Leone. You know, Reverend Jibril Bangura has become an interesting personality in America. This is your son. I understand that you raised him to be a Muslim. When he was born a Muslim.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, he became a Christian. He became a reverend. What do you think of that?
Well, really, Dandy, I don't feel bad about him.
Okay. Go ahead, just
so. I've been wanting for Lego be Muslim because I know say he come from Muslim home. But after me in them scatter, I left him, give me your sister one mommy one daddy for men. Now me don't go to Liberia. I get Liberia now, I hear say in don't turn pastor.
Mm-hmm.
And when I don't come I meet him, well, I decide I look say, well, once you don't be pastor, it's better for Lego be drunk man. Now treat.
Okay, it better make it be pastor.
Pastor than
for be a drunkard.
Drunkard, motorous
okay.
Drunkard.
Mm-hmm.
We go the pass now treat it and play gamble, you do all kind of bad thing. I say because we know say now this two religion now we get in the world.
I asked him, of course, what he felt about his son becoming a Christian after he had the family had rejected his becoming a Christian. And what he was telling me was that actually, his sister, that is the Sheikh's sister, raised Reverend Jibril Bangura. The sister, the Sheikh's sister, raised Reverend Bangura while the Sheikh was living in Liberia for many, many years. And when he returned to Sierra Leone, he discovered that his son had become a pastor. He was delighted. He looked at him. He was delighted because to him, being a pastor was better than this reverend becoming a criminal or smoking or drinking. So to him, the reverend become his son becoming a reverend was not an evil act. Rather, probably it was better for him to become what he is now than to have been otherwise.